Hello everyone, welcome to JSTM TSSM Group of Institute, Department of Civil Engineering. Myself, Professor Dushyanta Zamre, and right now we are standing in the strength of material lab. So for today's practical, we are going to perform a compressive strength on timber. This is a specimen for the timber. We have to know the dimensions for this particular test. For this, we are using this timber specimen. The dimensions for this timber are 50 mm, 50 mm, and 150 mm. Okay. While performing the compressive strength on this timber material, you can see the grains are there. These are the grains. So for this particular timber test, we have to take the test along the grain size and across the grain size. Means while applying the load, we have to apply a compressive load over this member in along the grain. These are the along the grain size and these are the across the grain size. Means once we have to put this specimen in this direction and another we have to put this specimen in this direction. So let's start with the practical. So this is the CTM, that is the compression testing machine. We are going to see or we are going to perform the compression test on timber over this machine. So these are the two load plates. This is the digital meter. These are the knobs, or we can say the gearing knobs. Below this there is a speed knob, which by using that knob we can control the speed of this application load. These are the hydraulic pipes which are connected to CTM load assembly. The load will be applied in upward direction with the help of hydraulic pressure. Now we are going to place this specimen. First, we are taking this compression test on this timber along the grain size. I have fixed this specimen and we have to lower down this plate, above plate, and then tighten it. Next procedure is thumb. Now we have to enter the values inside this digital meter. There are some buttons over here. This is the start button, this is the stop button. These are just like a joystick in the just like a mobile phone. These are the joysticks. And this is the tear button. We have to set some parameters. This is a round or square type. This must be a square type. So we have to change this into square type. Then next, again set the, we have to set the length. Length is 150 mm. This is proper. Okay. Then again, we have to set this. Width is 50 mm. So we have to make 50 mm. 050.0 set. Everything is set right now. Then next step is to start the process of loading. Before loading process, we have to make sure that this knob should be properly closed. Okay, now we will start with the loading process, application of loading process. Now you can see as the load is applying over this specimen, the specimen is getting cracked. Gradually and slowly the specimen is getting cracked. You can see there is a displacement over the upper portion of the specimen. Also, you can see
there is a failure from the side portion and upper portion. Majorly, the failure is taking place at the upper portion and the side portion of the specimen. You can see over here there is a failure, and here is also there is a failure taking place. Note down the ultimate load which was displayed on your digital screen and take the maximum load as a reading.
As you can see, this is the deformed portion of a timber material when load is applied on the along the grain size. In this way the timber gets failed. The next part is we have to place this specimen across the grain size. In this way we have kept the specimen across the grain size and lowered out the jaw.
Now the type will remain same, square type, but here we have to change the length. Now the length will be 50 mm and height will be, this is the length, will be, that is the height, 50 mm. Set width will be 150 mm. Set this all okay, then we have to close the knob and start the process of applying load. Here you can see the load is getting increased. The load is in kilonewton, and whatever the results we are getting, that is in newton per mm square.
Now you can see there is a sound of cracking.
The cracking sound is there. This shows that there is an application of compressive load over the grains of the timber. You can see the part of the timber is getting deformed. This much part is getting deformed. You can clearly see the crack inside the timber. Now the load is not getting increased in a rapid way. It will getting increased in a very slow manner. Increased gradually till the sample will get crushed, but we just have seen that the specimen is getting cracked, so we will stop the machine. So this is the load which we get, 118.5 kilonewton.
This is the deformed shape of the timber when the specimen is placed. So this is the, we have seen, this is the specimen when which we have placed perpendicular to the grains. These are the grains, and perpendicular to the grains we have applied the load. This is perpendicular to the grain size and this is the parallel to the grain size.
Now the calculation part. While performing the calculations, we have two specimens. One is parallel to grain size and another is the perpendicular to the grain size. This one is the perpendicular, this is the parallel grain size, and this is the perpendicular grain size. So first observation table will be, for each practical we have to take three consecutive readings. For this we have taken three consecutive readings. The dimensions of the specimen is 50 mm by 50 mm by 150 mm. The crushing load which we have got while solving the or while performing the parallel to the grain practical, that is 137 into 10 to the power 3 newton load, and compressive strength we have get 54.8. okay, then similarly second specimen is there, 121 into 10 to the power 3, the compressive strength we get 48.4, and similarly third is there, 83 into 10 to the power 3, this is the crushing load, and 33.2 is the compressive strength. Taking average of these three readings, we will get average compressive strength, that is in MPa, 45.45 MPa. Similarly, for the next, that is load applied perpendicular to the grain size, three consecutive readings were taken. First reading came as 85.5 into 10 to the power 3. Its compressive strength will be 11.4, which was we are getting in the digitalized meter. Then similarly, second and third one, the average of these three, which is taken over here, 11.6 MPa. So while finding the stress for load applied parallel to the grains, stress is equals to, that is sigma is equals to load upon area, first reading 137 into 10 to the power 3 upon the cross sectional area. How this compressive strength come? Its calculation is given over here, sample calculation, 137 into 10 to the power 3 upon 2500, that is 50 into 150, it will give you this area of this 50 into 50, you will get the area, and if you multiply it by 150, it will give you volume, but we required area for this particular sample. So 50 into 50, it will give you 2500 mm² area. Solving this, you will get a stress for this particular first reading, first set of reading. Then next is for this one, that is when load is applied perpendicular to the grain, stress upon stress is equals to load upon area, 85.5 into 10 to the power 3 upon 150 into 50, you will get the compressive strength in MPa, that is 11.4. Taking the average of these three readings, you will get the average compressive strength, which is applied parallel to the grain size, and this is the average compressive strength applied perpendicular to the grain size. So this is all about the observation and calculation part.
So this is all about the compression test on timber. As the application for this particular test is, why this test is going to be performed? Because while construction purpose, there are door frames, then window frames, we have to make frames of timber. So how much it can bear the compressive load which is coming from the upward side of that particular structure over that member, that we have to calculate. So for that purpose, we have to take the test on compression test on timber. This is all about the compression test on timber. Thanks a lot. Have a good day.